In this video, I'm going to show you how I use smart objects in Adobe Photoshop and why they are so beneficial for surface pattern designers and illustrators. A common challenge in surface pattern design is maintaining image quality when repeating a pattern. Scaling and transforming elements to create a seamless repeat often results in pixelation or distortion. Smart objects offer a non-destructive solution. By converting pattern elements into smart objects, you can then scale and transform them without compromising image quality. This ensures that the pattern can be repeated infinitely without losing clarity or detail. A smart object is a special type of layer that acts like a container for an image or a group of layers. You can change the size, you can apply filters, and you can even transform the smart object without damaging the original content inside. It's like having a protective case for your artwork. So if we were to compare smart object layers to regular layers are like basic building blocks in Photoshop. You can manipulate them directly by painting, erasing, or transforming. However, once you make those changes, they are permanent. You can't undo them without losing the changes. Smart objects are like protective containers for your layers, so they preserve the original image data, allowing you to make non-destructive changes. You can resize, rotate, apply filters, and even replace the original content without affecting the underlying image. It's like having a safety net for your design work. So let's have a look at how you can create a smart object in Adobe Photoshop. Okay, so let's jump into Photoshop and have a look at how to create or convert an element into a smart object. So I'm just going to create a circle using the marquee tool, and I'm just going to fill it with some color. And I'm going to duplicate that. So I'm just going to drag that layer down to the plus sign to duplicate it, and then use Command and T just to move it over. So now we have these two circles. I'm going to convert the second circle to a smart object. To do that, you just need to right click on the layer and then select Convert to Smart Object. And then if you have a look at it, it's got this little symbol here that represents a smart object. And what I'm going to do now is resize each of these. So let's grab the typical layer here and go Command or Control T. And then let's just scale that down a little bit. And then let's do the same to the other one. And then if we align them up together and zoom in a bit, you can probably see that the one on the left is slightly blurred around the edge, whereas the right one, which is the smart object, looks a lot crisper. So let's go even further. Let's select the non-smart object and do some more resizing. So I'm just going to make it smaller again, maybe make it bigger, and then maybe do some rotating. So every time you do a change like this, you move it, you rotate it, you scale it, it has to redo all the pixels. So let's do the same with the other circle. So we'll just resize it up, resize it down, let's do some rotations. Okay, and now if we jump in close, let's have a look. You can see now it's even blurrier than it was before, whereas the one on the right, which is the smart object, is looking a lot clearer. Now I am zoomed into 215%, which means you are going to get pixelation there, but if I was at 100%, which I am now, you can see the difference that the smart object looks a lot crisper. It's even the color is more brighter than the one on the left. So the one on the left is starting to lose the quality that it started out with. So the more you move things, the more you scale them, rotate them, the more quality you're going to lose on a layer that isn't a smart object. So let's just get rid of the original layer here and just work on the smart object layer. I'm just going to go out a bit and we don't, you want to check in this field up here, it's got width and height. You don't want to go above 100% because that's the original size that it was converted at. So leave that at that size. I'm going to create a few copies of that. So I'm holding down the Option key and you can see the two triangles there, and you can then click and drag to duplicate. Let's just create a few more. So when I'm creating a pattern, I often like to create multiple motifs. So if we jump over here into this pattern here, you can see there are multiple motifs. And when you have them all as smart objects and then copy them as I did with the circle here, you can go into just one of those and say I want to change the color to this pink. And then if I save and close that, they will all get updated. And this comes in really handy when you're working in patterns that have repeated motifs. So say I want to change these orange flowers. I just need to go into one of those smart objects. I can change the color, let's say this lighter blue, and then save and close that, and then all of them have been updated. This will save you a lot of time. And I'm just going to turn off the pattern preview as I want to show you another little nifty thing. You can apply filters and things like puppet warp to your smart objects and it won't affect the container, so it won't affect the original illustration. So say we want to use the puppet warp to bend one of these branches a little bit more. So if I just zoom in a bit here, and you need to do this with pattern preview off, otherwise it disappears. It's a bit of a glitch, I think, but I've got this one here selected. And if I go into edit and I go to puppet warp, and then let's just pin a few areas on there and then say bend it. This comes in handy when you want the motif to fit nicely around other ones. So I use this quite often, and then click the tick. So that has bent that. But if you go into it, you'll notice that it is still the original illustration. So it doesn't change what's in there. It's only changing the outer shell of that smart object, which is really handy. And also didn't change any of the others, even though they copies. The only way you can change all of them is to go into it and edit the original. So say I wanted to change the color to that green, then all of them will get updated to that green, as you can see there. And I'll undo that. So another thing I like to do, I'm going to jump into another pattern. I've created this pattern in what I call an OG template. And what I've done is I've grouped all those layers. If I go into the smart object here, you can see these are all my layers. I've got a sloth in a smart object. I've got all the leaves in a smart object, and I've got all the hearts in a smart object. So with OG patterns, you can create that original OG shape where you encase your motifs. And if you copy that smart object and then drag it up into the right corner or left corner, sorry, it should fit perfectly, and that creates that pattern. But say now I can see here there is a leaf quite close to this sloth's head. So I think I just going to want to reduce the size of just this sloth here. But what will happen is that it will also reduce the size of the other one down here. So if I jump into either one of those smart objects, I can grab that little sloth there and I can just down the scale a teeny tiny bit. And if I go back out and save it, you can see now there's a bit of a gap. So, and it has also updated the other group, smart object group. So that's a really handy way of updating a pattern as well when you're using these templates. And if you want to learn how to create an OG pattern, I have a tutorial that you could check out here. So just to recap, smart objects give you the freedom to experiment and try different things with your pattern motifs without the fear of ruining your original work. And they also allow you to effortlessly recolor and move multiple motifs all in one quick edit, saving you heaps of time. So I encourage you to start using smart objects if you use Photoshop. Use them in your pattern designs from now on, and you will quickly see the benefits. If you want to see how to use smart objects from start to finish in a pattern design, I recommend watching this video here where I show you how I use smart objects when creating a half drop repeat in Adobe Photoshop. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe so you get notified of all my videos. Till next time, happy pattern making. See ya.